entire team's dead, tries to run away. So I cast Sunstrike, but he notices and pops Pepper's insight. He gets hit by it and dies, and he's all like, what the fuck? And I'm all
just like, dire team bad.
And guys, we're actually got a game here down at the iPlay Infinite. It is the best of three, the final matchup between these two teams who have fought all their way here to the final. It is Team NZB who beat both Giga and Hesup We Trust and iPlay who lost their first game in the pool play to Cabbage Stack. No, wait, I miscast. This very same team. They were back, knocks down. Now they're back in the final playing against each other. Best of three. Winner takes about $700 worth of prizes home with him. The loser takes $100 cash. So this is a big game. And of course, if you win, you get to go home feeling $100 million. You get to feel great. You have those bragging rights to say, hey, you guys, you scrubs over there, you suck. So let's see how this game goes. We're going to jump straight into it because this is the best of three. And hopefully, we will be able to make up some time in our games because we have been running a little bit over. Straight into the game now. The first bans off the rank for both the teams. Nyx Assassin team and Lifestealer there for the iPlay team. Look, you know, we saw a lot of sneaky throughs of the Lifestealer in the earlier brackets, but now definitely being banned out along with OD. Those two heroes had some play. Now nobody wants to see them at all. And again, we see this highly unusual second pick ban off in the form of Keeper of the Light. This team does not like Keeper, you know. And I've said this before. A lot of teams book playing remaining. Keeper as part of their lineup because there's just so many other better supports to have. Instead, B picking up Weaver for the second time or third time. Look, you know, this is great. I like to see the teams repeat strategies that they know work. They know that they work. But hey, look, it's giving away too much as a first drop Weaver, second drop Naga is what they have for, and we see a clockwork for the first time, a clockwork in the lineup for the best of three. You know, clockwork very very strong, one of my favorite heroes in the offlane position or as a support clockwork because the power of those cogs is unbelievable. Look, I'm just looking at these drafts, sort of looking at how they're going to develop. I quite like Visage. I quite like Clockwork. Two very strong potential supports, potential carry in the form of Clockwork. They have this utility. They both have great killing potential, and they both have very good, solid initiation. So I play starting this draft strong, letting it know to NZB, this is how it is. You guys ain't the boss of me. We're going to show you how it goes. And they pick up Gyro to answer to iPlay's a strong pickup. So both teams picking up very very strong. Now this is the crux. This is the crux of the matter. You need to be sure with your bans here exactly how you want the game to unfold. If you pick the wrong bans, your opponent's going to be able to combo off much easier in such a way that you perhaps didn't see it coming. So both teams going to be paying much attention to each other's bans. Straight off the mark there, we see Shadow Demon being banned by the boss team. The boss is going, no Shadow Demon for you because we know the power of it. Lesh also being banned off very, very quickly. Both of those in the top tiers for support roles. Both of those very, very strong, particularly the Shadow Demon. Lesh, good in the roaming context, and we've seen a lot of play with Lesh. He has that strong pushing power with the towers, and you can't underestimate him. So both of those, easily warranting those third drop bans. Now we're into the final bans for the second ban phase. What are your thoughts, guys? I'm not seeing much action on the Twitch channel. Don't know if it's broken or not. Gonna open that up and make sure I'm looking at it during this next match, just to make sure I can say hi to you guys. Radiant team ban. When we have a Darkseer ban, yet again, Darkseer does not go through to a final matchup. You know, Batrider's still there, so someone may be playing Batrider, but we haven't seen a single Darkseer pickup in this entire event. And he's feeling a lot of hate. We've seen a few Lifestealers, we've seen a few ODs, we've seen a few Nagas, but we haven't seen any Darkseers. So good ban off there because he is strong. He warrants those. He warrants those that hate. You know, one of my favorite Akiris to play is a support character along with Tree, which we also haven't seen much of tonight. What are these teams remaining. Looking to ban out here? What are they looking to pick up, I should say, in the second set of banning?
Five I play. Remaining.
They're in a unique position here. They could reveal their trump gun and give away their mid play by picking up their puck, by picking up their Queen of Pain right now and giving it away as to what exactly their lineup's going to be. Or they could pick a support and just see how boss reacts to that pickup of a support. Anyone's guess at this stage. But this is a crucial game. You want to go into the best of three with the win. And they pick up an anti-mage. Is this going to be another fail mage, or are we going to see a well-oiled anti-mage? Remember, you can't touch this was this theme song that I played for anti-mage.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Some time being spent thinking exactly how they want to draft. They've revealed a serious trump cup in the form of this anti-mage. If left for 30 minutes, you can pretty much just pack up your gears and go home because you ain't going to be answering that. Though we did see in the last game an excellent shutdown by iPlay against the other team that's gone home already. They had that anti-mage. They had their potential to farm, but he was just given no room to pick up any farm, and that made it very, very difficult. So maybe they know how to play anti-mage, and perhaps they're not going to suffer from the same result. Boss picking up an unusual, this unusual third drop. Well, I should say unusual for drafting, but for this particular lineup, they've chosen to put Rubick up as their third slot support to go in with either Gyro and Weaver into their tri-lane. I'm a fan of a Rubick in the second drop, you know, because when you put Rubick into the second drop where Gyro is, the other team has to really think about their bans in terms of, oh, they've got a Rubick. We have to spend a little bit more time about thinking what our pickups are going to be. And it helps restrict your opponent's draft. But in this case, in the third drop, they've already committed to what their bans are going to be. They've already got an anti-mage on the table. So it's only two heroes they have to consider whether or not they do actually want to pick up now that you've got the Rubick in play. And a Chen being picked up, the micro of all micro heroes in my opinion, Dota 2. He is as powerful. You can almost guarantee that first blood if you get the right creep, and he is in that tri-lane support position with Visage and with somebody else more solid than anti-mage. You can almost guarantee that with that net creep, but does one spawn for you? You know, if you can get those body blocks off, you're gonna be an amazingly godsend, and you can always save a team with that hand of God. Plus, of course, once you get that mechanism, it's just so much extra HP for the enemy team to chew through. Puck.
Radiant team ban. Ten seconds remaining.
Some shoutouts going from this Twitch channel to the Dire. They remaining. Got this with the Visage Showdown. Let's see how the Visage auto win. They're saying, let's see how this actually unfolds. Puck being picked up by Boss. Bad. You know, Puck is a very good solid mid position. Who is going to be the mid for my play? It looks like if I was sitting in Boss's shoes, I'd be banning out that Queen of Pain right now, or that DK, because those are the two options I'd be looking to play if I was iPlay. You know, they've got this support chain. They've got remaining. Visage. He's going to be in the safe lane with the anti-mage. Clockwork's going to be in the long lane. They need Laser that mid slot. And they choose to ban out TA. That is also a very, very solid ban. We have seen some runaway TAs this week, particularly today. And TA coming back a little bit now, you know, it does require a little bit of farm, but there's refractions. Ah, who hates those refractions? I hate those refractions.
At the same time,
yeah, Queen of Pain, there it is, exactly as I called it. At the same time, with the Anti-Mage, with the TA pickup, it probably would have been best to leave it in the pool and ban out that Queen of Pain, because they have Gyrocopter, you know? Gyrocopter's flak damage is going to eat up those, those refraction charges, so it's not going to be as much of a threat. But Queen of Pain being picked in there, it was one of the heroes that they need for the mid position. A tough call there. They've gone with banning TA, and Queen of Pain is being picked remaining. Up. Queen of Pain puck normally slightly wins, but it comes to the positioning. It comes down to a little bit of foresight as to how you're going to go.
Reserve time.
And yes, and answering to one of the guys that has helped me out quite a bit with my graphical work. Yes, I'm flying solo. I am solo casting yet again. Running into 10 seconds to go. What hero are they going to pick up? Are we going to see an unusual hookup? They pick up Oge Magi because they're a little bit pigeonholed, a little bit restricted. Let's see if Boss can pull this through, or will it be the iPlay guys winning the second Dota 2 championship they've had here? I've been told in the break there was some kind of unofficial Dota 2 event previous before. That's how iPlay have come into existence. They were sponsored to return and add a team to the pool, and here they are at the finals again for this best of three. Let's go iPlay. Taking a bit of time to pick up those heroes now, but we're into the game. We can have a look now to see what it is exactly the strategy is in terms of the gameplay. Gamer pauses yet again. Here we go. Let's have a quick look at the items. Has there been a chance to buy items? No. So let's do a few quick plugins while we wait for whatever this pause is for. For those of you who don't know me, who are watching for the first time, I am Omega Kai. This is my Twitch channel, or this is my YouTube channel. If you like what you see, hit like, hit subscribe, because the more, or hit follow in the case of Twitch, because the more support I get, the more pulling power I have, and I'm much appreciated. It makes doing all this worthwhile. So if you like what you see, hit Twitch. If you don't like what you see, send me an email, and I will work on your constructive criticism as to where you think I can improve. Because hey, without criticism, you can't improve. Gonna do a plug in here while we wait for Southern Cross Dota. Southern Cross Dota is a community hub where you can go and put your information about your tournaments, or if you're looking to find out what tournaments are coming up, and go to southerncrossdota.com, sign up to their forums, have a look. They don't run their own events, you know, so it's not in competition of stuff. They're just looking to support the community and become a central place where information can flow. Out there, there's a lot of fragmented groups, there's a lot of events that go on, such as the event that I'm in now, that may not get as much promotion as they should, and they don't pull as many people as they should, because people just don't know about them. And that's why Vix down at the Southern Cross Dota group has come up with this platform, you know, and they've got casters. If you're looking to run events and you want casters, they've got people who like to do post-production stuff, they've got people that like doing graphical work, artwork. So if you've got these things that you want to do with an event, try and conscript some people by going on to southerncrossdota.com and signing up there, and you won't be disappointed. I've got no actual events. This is unusual. No events to actually plug in for once. Didn't come prepared. In any case, into the game. The thing that you guys actually care about. There is a DC. It has reconnected, so it looks like we may be going into the game any second. Same technical issue that we had for why it delayed the match in the first place was sound. Somebody has some kind of sound issue, and this is causing us a bit of delays here. This is the best of three, so let's see if the teams can play this concisely, because then we'll be able to move on to game two, and that will be the exciting clutch play right there. The first game, normally, you know, from experience, best of three, the first game tends to be a game where it's reasonably close, both teams play conservatively, then a few big plays come through, and then the game is won, you know. And it's only been in a handful of cases that I've casted that outside of like the professional circuit that you see on, you know, in TI3, in the sort of semi B tiers, if you will. Those who win the first game I think about 80 to 90% of the time they go on to win the actual best of three. And so winning this is the crucial game, you know. When you come into the second game and you've already down one, you're on the psychological back foot. You feel a little bit pressured, and sometimes you make calls, you make drafting decisions that are subpar because you choke, you know. And what are Kiwis known for? Kiwis are known for choking in sports and also in Dota. It's the same thing. We choke big time when the pressure's on. So this first game is going to be extremely important. While we wait, let's play the song. Let's play the anti-mage song, because I feel is it appropriate.
Can't touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this. My music hits me so hard, makes me say, oh my Lord, thank you for blessing me. What am I to run and to hype? It feels good when you know you're down. A super dope homeboy from the Oak Town, and I'm known as such. And this is a beat up. You can't touch it. I told you, homeboy, can't touch this. Yeah, that's how we living, and you know, can't touch this. Look at my eyes, man, can't touch this. Yo, let me bust the funky lyrics. Can't touch this.
Of course, anti-mage, you can't touch this, is unable to escape without a problem. He can just jump away, blanket at moment notice. And we saw in the last game that he did get hunted down a little bit. He did get cornered a little bit. And I did say, blink out of that at least one of the times where he was picked off. But hey, that's the song that I like to play for those miracle blinkaways. I'm just going to go check, guys, to see how things are going, because this is seem to be dragging on a little bit, and I just want to make sure that we're not delaying this unnecessarily. Just bear with me while I go and find out what's going on, because this is taking an awful amount of long time. And the game is being remade. I will rehost this very shortly. Sorry about that. I'm going to quickly jump in here when I find the game. And then I'll... wait, this doesn't look like it. No, this is it. This is definitely it. I will play some music in the meantime so that you guys are not totally bored looking at nothing.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. My music hits me so hard, makes me say, oh my Lord, thank you for blessing me. What am I to run and too hype me? It feels good when you know you're down. A super dope homeboy from the Oak Town, and I'm known as such, and this is a beat you can't touch. I told you, homeboy, you can't touch this. Yeah, that's how we living, and you know you can't touch this. Look in my eyes, man, you can't touch this. Yo, let me bust the funky lyrics. Touch this. Fresh new kicks and bands. You got it like that. Now you know you want to dance. So move out of your seat and get a fight going and catch this beat while it's rolling. Hold on. Bump a little bit and let the noise go on like that. Like that. Pull a little bit just to fall on back. Let them know that you're too much. And this is a beat they can't touch. Yo, I told you. You can't touch this. Why you standing there, man? Can't touch this. Yo, sound the bell. School is in, sucker. You can't touch this. Give me a song, a rhythm, making them sweat. That's what I'm giving them now. They know. You're talking about the hammer. You're talking about a show that's hyped and tight. Singles are sweating, so pass them a whiteboard tape to learn what it's gonna take in the 90s to burn the charts. Legit. Either work hard or you might as well quit. That's word, because you know you can't touch this. Can't touch this. Break it down. Stop. Hammer time.
Right, it seems we're back into the game, hopefully. Game one. Same lineup. Let's see if we actually have a game between iPlay, Internet Cafe, hosted team, and New Zealand boss. Let's hope that we actually progress into this game, because it is an important milestone game for this particular event. Best of three. It is late. So let's go and see what we can do. I assume they're just checking out the audio there. Hopefully it's all fixed, because this is dragging on for sometimes, and it is going. Hoorah! We while the sound audio issue has been resolved, someone has actually crashed, which is hilarious. I guess not so much for those who have been sitting around since 8 o'clock this morning watching me, but definitely for those who are hoping to see a game unfold before their eyes, before they hit the hay. You may not see one, guys. You may not see one at all. So just going to recap on the pickup and the lineup for both teams. Although you can see it on your screen, I need something to talk about. So here we go. Chen, that hero that requires micro in the jungle. You know, if you can find those early net creeps, you can secure those first bloods. But also, if you just have an entire lineup of those net creeps, you can be a force to reckon with. The biggest range creep, damage creep there is. So if you've got aura based effects from some of your other teams, that can be quite a lot of right clicking just there. Visage has that powerful nuke with the slow, and again another hero micro, so he works well with the with Chen. They can really push down towers together, just those two with their army of little mini army of creeps. Anti-mage, that guy, if you leave him alone to farm for 30 minutes, he will find you, he will kill you, and he will break away, and there'll be nothing you can really do about it. Queen of Pain dominates the mid as one of the best mid position heroes, and she has that squealing death scream that you what you would envision when you see a woman wearing black walking down the road. She says she's in a death metal band. She's a Queen of Pain. She can scream until you bleed. And then of course we've got Clockwork, who's really good in that long lane position, who can cog it up. Great, great initiation with the hooks, you know. He can really, really jump into position and smash it away. In any case, rolling it over to the other team now, the Dai team. Puck, probably there's not many heroes that can outmid a Puck. There are some scenarios where it doesn't work out so great for him. But you know, Queen of Pain Puck is quite a common lineup. Puck generally wins out because of the silence if he can land it before he gets nuked out. He adds to the team fight through the Dream Call, and he has that great flexibility with his orb as well as the team utility with AoE silence. Ogre Metro is very similar in the fact that he has this great 2 utility. He has a lot of passive ults, and he does have a stun so he can lock down. Gyro, we all know how Gyro works. AoE damage in your face, can't run away from it. Boom, 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 boom. And of course, Rubik, pseudo support sort of role, good at stealing, good at positioning, can also lock you down with his stun and help secure some kills. So Weaver being a greedy carry, lots of escapes, heaps of dive potential, but let's look at the lanes here. It is a tri lane in the bottom lane going into the Radiant jungle. Radiant doesn't seem to have any be aware just yet. They're actually looking from avenues to escape. They were expecting this, and it's going to be a quick engagement. There's a pickup from the anti-mage. He does blink away. You can touch this. No first blood. Probably would have been better to pick up the gyro if they could have, because there's no way that gyro is going to be able to get away like that. Meanwhile, Chen looks like he's going into the jungle slash mid position as jungle. Queen of Pain mid, and we've got solo Clockwork going up against a solo Weaver, mid also being Puck as we expected. And it's actually a dual lane in the bottom lane of Gyro and Ogre Magi. Going up against a tri lane of Anti-Mage. Anti-Mage Visage Duke. So how's this thing going to fall? Anti-Mage and Visage, they need to be a little bit careful. They need to wait for this Chen to be in position to come out. They've completely warded out this jungle, so Chen's going to find it difficult to find any kind of creeps. Where is Chen? Good question. He's actually gone to their jungle to find creeps, because he knew he couldn't find any in his own. Very smart move. In fact, he's now going to be able to add some support. He does have that creep that we talked about. He is going to be able to secure our first blood, and it is going to happen very, very shortly. And in fact, we may see first blood happen right now. Is it going to unfold? But in front of my eyes, punch comes out. There's a stun. Here comes the net. He's got no jaunt. He can't escape. Right clicking. Is there enough damage? Is there enough? First blood going to Chen. As I said, without a doubt, you could get first blood with that net creep. And I wasn't wrong, I delivered! Thanks, Chen, for making me a right man! Puck, and now you're gonna be on the back foot, 007. He needs to pull out the Mission Impossibles, it's the wrong genre. He needs to pull out the Money Penny, he needs to get the deals, and he's going up against Queen of Pain, and he's already down. Queen of Pain 3, he's 3, but you know, of course, that extra XP gold assistance is gonna help out Queen of Pain in the mid lane. Meanwhile, these tri lanes going head to head in the bottom, they are going to suffer a little bit. They're going to find it difficult. I should say, the Radiant's going to find it difficult, because for all intents and purposes, it's a dual lane. You know, Chen's about, but he's not always about. He's going to be doing a lot of rotating. And you can see here, he's looking to do something. They're coming into play, they're coming to D ward. Chen with a haste rune, is he going to do anything? No, he's just going to play a little harassment. That's weird. Would have been much more effective on the anti-mage, or at least being able to get in position so that you can body block with that haste rune. But hey, he's chosen just to use it up to get some harassment out, so it's not a complete waste. Anti-Mage, let's look at CES, because it's going to be important to see whether or not this Anti-Mage is going to get anything. He's sitting on 2 CS, 2.5 minutes into the game. That's piss poor. He needs to lift his game, otherwise he's not going to be able to be effective in their mid-game phase where they desperately need him. When Queen of Pain starts to teeter off, that's when Anti-Mage needs to take off. And if they've got this big gap in their mid-game phase, it does mean they're gonna, it's going to be a big opening there for NZB. Meanwhile, Queen of Pain leading the CS in the mid lane, dominating this Puck, who's got less than half the CS because of that early kill, and now he's playing very defensively and he's staying away from this Queen of Pain as much as possible. In the top lane here though, however, Clockwork sitting on a 10 CS to Weaver's 9 CS, so it's almost even. Oh, and we have a kill in the bottom lane, an engagement, Flat Cannon goes down, they're trying to hunt him down. And it is going to be a dead chain, one right click away. Nice body blocking with the creep. The stun going to be up in 3, 2, 1, stun. Not using the stun. Ruben pick up, Flat Cannon. Visage going to go down again. 2 for 2. 2 for 2. And well played by both teams. Bit of a miss by me. Anyway, in terms of CS, in the bottom lane, Gyro sitting okay with 13 CS, but you know, the real winner here is definitely that Queen of Pain. She's getting a roaring ripper of a start, and she's going to be able to exploit that, particularly in the next few minutes. Stashy, now that she's picked up an invisibility rune, what she needs to do is rotate into one of these overpush lanes, and booyah, extra kills, no problem.
Thought you had that, didn't you?
Clockwork getting close to level 6. Once he gets that hook, he needs to look at rotating. You know, his power is really disrupting the enemy in their lanes. I forgot to add this to my disruption of our heroes list. You know, he can really displace people, so he needs to consider rotating and helping out his buddies in the bottom lane if that lane gets overextended. Because this Anti-Mage, not getting any farm. Chen is more farmed than Anti-Mage, and that's a sad affair. Smoke up from Chen. Chen had the negative. No opportunity there to use the smoke, so just looks to pull through. Nice pull through. Good double pull there. It's going to give this Anti-Mage a lot more XP. He's going to get levels. He's not going to get CS against this tri-lane, but he's going to get levels. He's going to survive. As long as he doesn't throw away their blink, he will be fine. Meanwhile, Queen of Pain really dominating the middle. 31 CS, more than double the CS of the Puck. This is not good news. Let's see if that converts to net worth. Yeah, net worth-wise, wow, way above Puck. Not far from Gyro though. Gyro's not too far away, so Gyro is really working well. He is going to have to be that mid-game gap that they're talking about. But look how much damage they've got. Queen of Pain, Visage is really their nuking combo. With a little bit of follow-through here with Anti-Mage once he's farmed, and Cogs from the initiation Cogs from Clockwork. So it needs to really go onto Anti-Mage this farm, and not as well. He needs to catch up. He needs to get the CS. Both teams taking it very cautiously. They know the importance of this first match. It's 2 for 2. No one's in favor. No one's in the lead. Though, the laning wise, it is Dire winning the bottom lane, and it is Dire. Was they winning the top? No, it's pretty even in the top. It's just Dire. Dire losing mid but winning bottom. Meanwhile, there's an engagement here. They're driven back in the bottom lane. They turn. They sense blood. Blink already going, being used. 6 seconds. No follow through. Wow, so much damage going down onto a lot of heroes, including Gyro. They have to back up. They have no choice here. This Ogre Magi, he's tanky, but he needs to look out.
Dire's middle tower is not what it used to be. That is for certain.
Gyro checking the chance. He's going to stick around, act as bait. He wants to add his damage to the next engagement.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Rubik's there. He's ready to go in. But of course, you can't touch this. Anti-Mage knows that he can blink out if he gets into a dangerous position. Another rotation. There's a rotation in front park. It's a smoke rotation. They're going to hunt for blood and they're going to find it. But are they going to find it in the form of Anti-Mage? Or are they going to look for this Visage? They go for Visage. They know Anti-Mage has got an escape. They're getting so close. They see Chen. There's the pickup. There's the orb. Jaunt. No jaunt required. Silence kill off. There's Visage. And he gets killed. He gets taken out by Visage. Dream Coil! Amazing plays! Can they finish a one more right click? One for one, two for two, four for four. It's even up. Queen of Pain coming in to do the cleaning up. Ding, ding, ding! Clean up on aisle three! Anti-Mage gonna secure that kill. And he needed that! He needed that net worth to help him drive up that chart. Really did. And iPlay take the advantage for the first time, or I should say, yeah, for the first time. They take the advantage, they're in the lead, force the buyback out of Puck as well, and much needed gold onto Anti-Mage, who now jumps up that table to second net worth, where he needs to be if he's going to be ineffective in that late game. Meanwhile, on the top lane, Cogs does not save Clockwork, and then now five for five. Puck picking up that, and instead of Weaver.
Axe observes carnage underway.
That's okay. Puck plays well all the way through. He doesn't really peter off. He has the same level of power all the way through the game, so that's not a bad thing. Puck picking up some extra kills. Would have preferred that on Weaver, however, because, you know, if you can rush out that MK Monkey King Bar or that Desolator on, you can really turn the tide of the game. But, you know, a kill's a kill. Kill secure. 5 for 5. Let's see now where the engagement is. It's going to be in the bottom lane. They're coming in for the kill. Look at them. They're descending on him. He's got nowhere to go. There's the slow. There's the nuke. Here comes the flat cannon. There's the net. Easy kill, and there's a cancel TP, waste of 135 gold. Great play there by iPlay. They pick up two kills, also in the form of Queen of Pain picking off, I don't know who he picked off in the top lane. Picked off Weaver in the top lane. So while that was going on, Queen of Pain rotated top and also got a kill. Excellent, excellent rotation. Good coordination here from our iPlay team, showing why they are the champions and why they were sponsored by the store.
Much like Cordwood before Axe's Axe, Dire's top tower is under attacks. Dire's middle tower is not what it used to be, that is for certain.
Then on the bottom, Dream Call catching Anti-Mage. He does one right click away. He gets picked up by Rubick with a Fate Bolt. They're chasing him down. They're looking for something. Chen's out of position. There goes the orb. One more record. Johnson picks off the chin. The flexibility of Rubick coming through.
If Dire's middle tower was worth a damn, it would still be standing.
And I am being berated slightly for my call of an amazing dream. You're absolutely right. It was a pretty standard dream call earlier on. But hey, at the time, I thought it was amazing. That's probably how... Yeah, that's how you call it, and yeah, it wasn't the bestest call, but hey, that's the deal. Thanks for that criticism. In any case, NZP tying up, amazing hook. That was an amazing hook. That was so far away. It managed to get it just on the outskirts of its range, but unfortunately, not securing a kill. Rubick. Whoa! Look at all the damage going down. Was secured by Anti-Mage. Visage goes down to a barrage of damage coming out of a number of players, including Gyrocopter, who does pick up that kill. But it's a 2-for-1. They need one more kill to tie it up. Here comes the cooldown. But Queen of Pain blinks away with that powerful blink. I play yet again, taking the advantage, taking the initiative here, and but leading the charts just slightly.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
I do think it did go to them slightly. I think it's because it did go to them, obviously, because they are in the lead. Graph-wise, 4K gold, 5K experience almost, and it's looking reasonably bad for NZB. Even though they can't see the graphs that we can see, but it's definitely in the favor of the Radiant team. They only need to keep this momentum up, and all this excellent rotation from both teams playing at high-level Dota. Rocket Flare revealing some of the heroes who had dusted and smoked up.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
And Visage overextending his welcome. He's gonna get picked off. What was he thinking? Dreamcore with a cooldown. Chen uses his ult. Punk goes down. Who else is gonna go down? Rocket Barrage. Ult's being used. Ribbit goes down. And Ogre Mage goes down, and the word F! I can hear a fuck being screamed out in the other room as somebody dies. Whoa, hookshot! In goes the hookshot, followed up by Queen of Pain. Great initiation there.
Dire's bottom tower is under
but, Clockwork tower. Dude, what Clockwork does well. You know, that's why I'm happy to see him being used. Executing those excellent kills, and now I play extending that lead to a 4-kill lead. And the graphs, I don't want to look at the graphs because I already know what it's going to tell me. It's going to tell me this is an Amigo snowball already underway. But let's just see if NZB, the Dire team, can redeem themselves because they've played so well already all the way through. They did beat them in the first round, so they can beat iPlay. It's not like iPlay's this unbeatable team. They did beat them in the best of one, so they can do it.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Of course, net worth wise, let's have a look at items. Haven't looked at items for a while. Let's just review these items. Oh, we can see BKB being built onto the Queen of Pain very, very early BKB. We've got Battlefield almost complete onto the Anti-Mage. What else? Boot conversion all been complete on the iPlay team. What else? Number of other abilities earned in there. Nothing too amazing, but I do like to see the fact that they're on their way to a Mechanism, on their way to a Battle Fury, and on the way to a BKB. Meanwhile, on the NZB team, they are trailing a bit. Only two of the heroes have got boot conversion from standard boots into other boots, and they're lacking any of those build items into build items, so they're actually way behind on items, even though the graphs, which I failed to look at, tell another story. They tell me this is iPlay's game to throw. Has plateaued a bit, but look at those item advantage, you know?
Axes pleased!
Missed that, unfortunately. Good engagement there by Clockwork. Oh wow, and Puck is Puck is getting into play, manages to catch Chen.
May you ride on Nether Zephyr.
Killing spree!
Wow, Anti-Mage coming out of nowhere to throw down the damage with his ult. There's a pause, there's a DC. It's 15-5 in favor of iPlay, who have just ramped up their play. Red Dots are really quiet at the start, and then boom! Or skyrocketing in a way. Anti-Mage, I think if I check the courier, we'll see that the Anti-Mage may or may not have where's the courier? Yeah, Anti-Mage completed his Battle Fury, I believe. Bit of a scrub at the moment. Yeah, he's completed his Battle Fury, so he's got that Battle Fury. It's on time, 16 minutes, it's on time, 14-16 minutes, that's a timely Battle Fury. So you can't say much about that, but it is good to see that he has got that Battle Fury. He is going to be a force to reckon with. Meanwhile, wow, she's so close. In fact, I do believe she can convert that immediately into a Black King bar. In a few more hits, she'll have a BKB. So these early core items coming out for the Radiant team, they're going to start to really punish this Dire team once they get them in hand. Chen, same with Chen. He's a little bit behind. He needs a few more few more last sets of a few more minutes in order to farm up those that headdress so he can build his way to that mechanism. But you know, well on the way I play, whereas the team, they are behind the ball. They do need to suck it up a little bit and look for some good team fights. Otherwise, they're going to be a problem. The problem is really they don't have enough. The Rubik doesn't have level 6. Weaver, he doesn't. He's a whoa. Where did his health ring go? Did he sell that? Weaver, I feel like Weaver's behind the ball a bit. He's had. You know, Weaver needs that. I don't like this. How Weaver requires so many items to Radiant's affect him with his damage. For a lot of carries. But attack. I just feel that Weaver, you need that Lincoln Sphere, and without it, you're not going to really come. You need that Lincoln Sphere and that BKB. Otherwise, you're not going to be able to really commit to a team fight.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack!
Yeah, regrouping now. Weaver in a bit of trouble. They need some items here. Items being completed on the other team now mean that they're going to start to push and be aggressive. And you can see here that there's pings going down. Defend this tower! Because they sense there are a number of heroes in the area, including an invisible Rubik, who's looking to come in and try and pick up somebody. They want Visage, if they can find him. But no, they're backing up. They're also choosing to play very, very carefully. They know a missing call's coming. Down the river comes Clockwork. He does have vision, so he can hook. And he is looking for that opportunity to hook somebody, but it's not presenting itself. In fact, the Dire team, they have chosen to retreat from defending their tower and pull right back because they know they're not in the best position. AT Mage being asked to come on through and to add his support by pushing this bottom lane and then crossing over to mid and then finally going up to the top lane. Meanwhile, stacking going on with the Ogre Badger of the Ancients. And he's here to try and stop Anti-Mage, but there's not much he can really do. These teams, they really need to start initiating, especially the iPlay team. They've got that initiation. They can utilize it well. They can definitely find somebody here.
Under attack.
They're being cautious now that they've got this lead. They don't want to throw it away. They've given away their position, though. They've announced it by pulling these line creeps, these wave creeps. And this is just keeping the Dire team back a little bit, being harassed by Rock Affairs, driven back slightly. They don't want to engage. They now pulled the lane, and they've definitely got this tower. Meanwhile, Anti-Mage scaling like a snowball, out of control. Got his Battle Fury now building towards his Dreads. No, what? Dreads? What's he building with this? Confused. Amiga is confused.
Dire's top tower is under
yes.
attack.
Yep, I see. He's going to disassemble the Tranquil Boots, build himself some treads, and then use those disassembled parts to build the Sage's Mask and the other thing into a Vladimir's Mask. So that's a wise pickup there by the Anti-Mage. Very efficient use of items.
Much like
meanwhile, pushing on the tier 2, unchallenged, yet still. They're going to pick up this tier 2. No answer out of the Dire team. In fact, they've fallen back to tier 3. They've given up tier 1 and tier 2 without the best of challenge. And no, this is the best of 3 challenge. So there is potentially two more games to go. But it's looking like it's definitely going in favor of the iPlay team at this point in time. Yeah, this Queen of Pain, look at the net worth. Net worth says Radiant, Radiant net worth. And Dire, no Dire, no net worth. So, poor, very, very poor. Let's have a look. Yep, it's a snowball, definitely a snowballing effect. Radiant's you can't escape this one, guys. As much as you fight this, you're going to find it difficult to claw back that 10,000-13,000k deficit in both gold and XP. Not impossible. Not impossible, but you can find it. What do you say? What do you say? Come on, let's go. The rating team, they're hovering around Rush. It looks like they're trying to set up. Looking like they're sitting out for something, potentially a Rush attempt. It's watered though, so it's not probably advisable. The Dire, they see this movement in the Rush area. They come in to potentially engage and also pick up this very, very stacked Ancients camp. So that's going to be much needed gold going their way, helping them claw back up their table. But it's all Gyro. It's all Gyro. He needs to save this Dire team. I mean, they've got some good plays. 007, he's played his puck exceptionally well. I feel he has. He's coming at the right moment when he needed to. Helps sort of almost in this initiation type puck. That's what puck does. But he's done it well. And I think he deserves... Right, as we go there, as I'm being told right now, actually, NZB is up one, best of three. They haven't lost a single game, so they've actually been awarded the first win. So if they win this, actually, they'll be it, they'll be game. But unfortunately, I playing very strong, driving at home, so it will be 1-1. That means there'll only be two games for this best of three. Time being part of the factor here also. I feel that if we'd done this much earlier, they wouldn't have awarded that win there to be NZB. But hey, them's how the cookie rolls. The saying is that's how the cookie crumbles, but I don't like that saying because cookies don't always crumble. The high ground position being given away by those creeps, so they might as well abandon any attempt to gank from there. They know that they're there, they can't quite see them, but they know that they're there. They've got illusions hanging around also to give them this extra field of vision. So they all have to do now is just put damage down onto the tower, and that's exactly Hooker bite! Hooker, but he doesn't land the cogs. In fact, he gets silenced! Queen of Pain's there! Gyro comes from behind with Weaver! Queen of Pain picks off Rubick! But now, where's she gonna go? Gyro picks off Visage. Queen of Pain escapes through the back door. And that was a good trade there. Visage for Rubick. Even trades. Good engagement. Both teams responded very, very well. Though, maybe a little bit delayed here. Didn't save the tower enough. Meanwhile, Sneaky anti-mage does sneaky anti-mage things. Does he have enough damage? That's the question. Can he sneak out this? I don't think so.
Radiant's top tower has been denied.
Well, he's gonna do it. Meanwhile, DDB gonna be picked up here by Weaver. He's looking. He's gonna now look for a target. He's gonna probably see that. There is a Visage in the vicinity and a Rubick, Clockwork in the vicinity of the mid lane, so he's going to hang around there. Meanwhile, the anti-mage is going to pick up this Roshan. Nice and sneakily, just enough damage. Just enough damage to do it. And he's going to build those pipes to add to his already natural magic resistance. And for those of you who say, oh, that doesn't stack, it does. Natural... Spell Shield does stack with item resistance. It's just that item resistance doesn't stack with itself. So, Anti-Mage is going to be impervious to a degree from all this magical damage coming out of the enemy team. Damage coming out of Park, damage coming out of Rubick and Ogre-Mage. But I do think the damage that comes out of... the damage that comes out of Gyro is still physical damage. In any case, it's slowing down a little bit. The farm's still going on, though. It is still Radiant much higher than the Dire, but the Dire have managed to claw back some victories here. But they might be throwing it away here! Out of position, Queen of Pain!
Your queen is dead.
What ingratitude?
Another clawback here by Dire. Let's have a look at those graphs. Let's see which way they've indicated. Even though they've been throwing a little bit, look at the graph's still going up. The graph is still going up. It's because this anti-mage. Because of this anti-mage and this Queen of Pain are just picking up so much CS. So much last
attack.
And he's feeling so confident. He's going to waste a blink on initiating on a tower. And because he just wants to be there to get extra gold. He's got his Manta Blade. He's got his Manta Style. He's got his Battle Fury. He's got a Vlad's. I thought he was building into a Pipes, but I was wrong. He's building into a Vlad's. He didn't really need to do that, I don't think. But he feels he needs to do it for that extra lifesteal war damage. That's how he got the Rosh. He's got the token. And he's out of control. He is by my standards. How do you stop this? How do you stop this? You know? You can't touch this anti-mage out of really pushing down the lanes, and he's just going to utilize that blink every time it's up. You know, and this sounds really, really dumb, but you know, if he got a 4-star, he would never, never need to walk. 4-star blink, kill something, blink, 4-star blink. In any case, anti-mage farming up a storm, really extending his CS lead to being almost double that of Gyro. So he is particularly farmed, and they're now making assault, sieging this tier 3 in the mid lane. They're poised to take this. They're just waiting for this creep wave, and then I feel that they're just going to dedicate themselves to this because they're so far ahead. Pipes being blown early because they want to charge on L up the hill. Yeah, and there's no answer. Hook comes in. Hook shot. Can't get the cursor. Doesn't matter. Call down. Anti-mage. There's a scream. Down goes the mechanism. Hand of God. They turn the tide. 3-1. Buybacks coming out of the Dire team. Rubik. Not going to be enough. Net creep. Another player goes down from NZB. This is the mid-setter Rax.
Dire's middle tower has fallen. Tend to your wounds.
And I believe if they take this tower, if they take this setter Rax, it should be GG here. This anti-mage far, far beyond the reach of NZB. What are they going to do? Don't think they could do anything.
Unstoppable.
Consider thyself.
Look at that, just so much damage going down, and there's nothing they can do about it. Rotating into the bottom.
Tower is under attack.
Taking this tower.
Radiant found the weakness in Dire's bottom tower. Like many a barrack before it, Dire's bottom barracks.
And yeah, this is going to be a double Rex, potentially a triple Rex, if the Dire make a mistake and commit to a battle here, and it looks like they are! Call down all the abilities going down onto anti-mage. He's still got the Aegis. It's being reclaimed in 1 minute. He wants to die. And it only had 50 seconds to being reclaimed. Comes back. Loves it. Picks up 3 more kills. Potentially a 4th. Yeah, it's going to be a 4th kill. There.
Radiant's top tower is under attack! Monster kill!
And this should be GG. Why are they GGing? This game is clearly the iPlays. They're not gonna throw this. They've got the farmed anti-mage. Anti-mage is now, he's not gonna even bother with he's not even gonna bother with the top racks. I think he's just gonna go straight for the throne.
Dire's middle tower
is not pushed out.
What it used to be, that is for certain.
No, he's going to try and backdoor it. He is going to try and backdoor it. And he is successfully doing it. This tower does see a dead body within its sight range, so it isn't going to get regeneration Vector regeneration. For those who don't know, it's about dead corpses and live creeps, some weird mechanic. Vector protection not being triggered. Mega creeps coming into play, and this should be GG. This is GG. Players just playing out for damage. Hook's going down! GG! And I play, go on to the next game. One up, or one for all. I don't really know, I'm going to talk to the organizers. I am slightly confused, because best of three doesn't normally work this way. But it still is at least one game under the belt for iPlay. I'll bring you the results once I talk to the organizers. Thanks for watching. Anti-Mage does it again.
Can't touch this.